गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 11 स्टूडेंट्स. सो दिस इज़ योर सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स एंड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग इन दिस लेक्चर द असाइनमेंट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3 and 4 बिकॉज टुमारो यू विल बी हैविंग टेस्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द असाइनमेंट. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज टू अ मैन गोइंग ईस्ट इन अ कार विद अ वेलोसिटी ऑफ 40 km/h. A train appears to move towards north with a velocity of 40√3 km/h. What is the actual velocity and what is the direction of motion of the train? Okay, so VC, that is velocity of car, is given to be 40 km/h, and velocity of train with respect to car is given to be 40√3 km/h. Okay, so now you have to calculate actual velocity of the train. So to calculate actual velocity, we will be using resultant formula, that is under root of VC square plus VTC whole square, because as you know, VTC will be nothing but VT minus VC. So that is in vector form. So when you will calculate magnitude, you will get this. So just put their values and solve it. You will get 80 km/h. Okay, so now this is the actual velocity. Now in the question, direction of motion of the train is also asked. So as you have done in theory lectures, the direction of motion will be calculated by tangent theta, and that will be VC upon VTC, that is 40/40√3. When you will solve it, you will get the answer to be 30° east of north. Okay, so the second question says the velocity of particle P due east is 4 m/s and that of Q is 3 m/s due south. What is the velocity of P with respect to Q? So again, you are given VP, that is velocity of P, to be 4 m/s, velocity of Q to be 3 m/s. So the velocity of P with respect to Q will be, we will be using the the formula of relative velocity, that is VP minus VQ, or you can say under root of VP square plus VQ square. So this will be the magnitude of this vector. So when you will put the values and solve it, you will get 5 m/s. Okay, so to calculate the direction, let us calculate again tangent theta as we did in first question. So that will be VQ upon VP. Put the values and solve it. This will come to be 0.75. So theta will be tangent inverse of 0.75, or you can say 36 degree north of east. So this will be the velocity of P with respect to Q in the north of east. In question number 4, you are given an equation of distance depending on time, that is S is equals to T cube minus 6T square plus 3T plus 4. So you have to calculate that velocity at which your acceleration becomes 0. So now if distance is given to you, I hope you know how to calculate velocity and acceleration. So by doing differentiation of distance with respect to time, first of all, we will be calculating velocity. So when you will differentiate it, differentiation of t cube will be 3t square minus 6t square. Differentiation of this term will be minus 12t, and differentiation of 3t will be plus 3, and differentiation of 4 will be 0. So this is the velocity in terms of time. Now again, to calculate acceleration, we will be again differentiating this velocity with respect to time. So that will give you differentiation of this will be 60. Minus differentiation of 12t will be 12, and differentiation of 3 will be 0. Now in the question, it is asked you have to calculate that velocity at which your acceleration becomes 0. That means this part should become 0 because this is nothing but acceleration. So when this is 0, that means 60 is equals to 12. So from here t will come to be 2 seconds. So now to calculate velocity when acceleration is 0, put value of t equal to 2 seconds here and solve it. You will get the value of velocity to be minus 9 m/s. That is, at this much velocity, the acceleration will become 0. In question number 5, again, I am just telling you the formulas. You have to use the formula of velocity, that is magnitude of velocity, and tangent theta as we did in question number 1. So use these formulas and you will get the answer same. Okay, so it is an easy question. Try it yourself. I am leaving it for you. Okay, so next is question number 6. It says, show that the maximum range of a projectile in any direction is described in the same time in which it would fall freely under gravity through this distance starting from rest. Okay, so for that, as you know, for maximum horizontal range, the angle of projection should be 45 degree. So maximum horizontal range will be equal to u square upon g sine 2 into 45. So this will be sine 90, that will be 1. So maximum horizontal range will be u square upon g. Now if you calculate time of flight for the angle of projection of 45, that will be 2u by g into sine 45. So sine 45 is 1 by root 2. So 2 by root 2 will be root 2. Okay. So you will get root 2u by g. So this is your maximum horizontal range and this is your time of flight. Now let us consider vertical motion. So as you know, in vertical motion, u will be 0. Acceleration will be equal to acceleration due to gravity. You have to calculate distance and t will be equal to root 2u by g as you have calculated here. So just use the equation s is equals to ut plus half a t square. By using that equation of motion, you can easily calculate the distance will come to be u square upon g. So this is proved because this is same as that of maximum horizontal range. In question number 7, it is given a bullet fired from a rifle attains a maximum height of 5 meter and crosses a range of 200 meter. Then calculate the angle of projection. Okay, so students, understand it carefully. Maximum height, maximum height is given to be 5. So we will be using the formula of maximum height, which is u square sine square theta upon 2g. And according to question, this quantity is given to be 5. After that, in question, you are given a range of 200 meter. And again, you know the horizontal range, the formula of horizontal range, that will be u square sine 2 theta upon g. This is given to be 200 in question. So now let us divide these two equations. So when you will divide them, you will get 5 by 200. This u square will cancel out. And when you will solve it, you will get 1 by 4 tangent theta. Okay. Just put sine 2 theta is equals to 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay. So now when you will again solve it, theta will come to be nearly equal to 5 degrees. So this is the angle of projection for which height will be 5 meters and horizontal range will be 200 meters. Okay, so in question number 13, it is asked, can there be motion in two dimensions with an acceleration only in one dimension? So the answer is yes, it is possible. For example, in angular projection, that is in projectile motion during angular projection, as you know, acceleration acts vertically downwards, that is g, but projectile follows a parabolic path. That means motion is in two dimension, but still acceleration is only in one dimension, that is vertically downwards. Okay, so next is question number 14. In that you are given, if a projectile has a constant initial speed and angle of projection, find the relation between the changes in horizontal range due to the change in acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so for that, you need to first of all know the formula of horizontal range, and that is nothing but u square sine 2 theta upon g. Okay, so now you have to calculate the change in r with respect to change in g. So what we will be doing, we will just differentiating this term with respect to g. So this quantity will become dr by dg equal to u square sine 2 theta. That is common, that will come outside of differentiation. So differentiation of 1 by g with respect to g is minus 1 by g square. So that will be minus upon g square. Okay, so now from here, if you calculate dr, that will come to be minus u square sine 2 theta upon g into dg by g. So I am just writing g square as g and g. So from here, if you calculate, or you can say from, if in this term you divide by r, that is this term. So here, this will be dr by r. When you will divide it by r, u square sine 2 theta, this term will cancel out. And 1 g will also cancel out. So you will be left with minus dg by g. So this is the relation between the changes in horizontal range due to the change in acceleration due to gravity. In question number 18, it is given a swimmer crosses a flowing river of width d to and fro in time t1. Okay, now the time taken to cover the same distance up and down the stream is t2. If t3 is the time for the swimmer that he would take to swim a distance 2d in still water, then prove that t1 square is equals to t2 into t3. So for that, first of all, let us suppose u and v are the velocities of swimmer in still water and river water. Okay, so according to question, t1 is the time taken by the swimmer to go to and fro for a distance d. So that means total distance in going from to and fro will be 2d, and the resultant speed will be u square minus v square. So this is your t1. Now according to question again, t2 is the time taken to cover the same distance up and down. So for up, time will be d upon u plus v, and again for down, it will be d upon u minus v. So when you will solve it, you will get 2ud upon d square minus v square. Okay, so now, and t3 is that time which the swimmer takes to swim a distance of 2d in still water. So that means distance is 2d. And we have assumed the speed u to be in still water, so that will be 2d by u. Now you know each value, that is t1, t2 and t3. So just calculate t2, t3. That is multiply this and this. You will get 4d square upon u square minus v square. Now compare this term with the first term. So this is nothing but t1 square. So hence it is proved that t2, t3 will be equal to t1 square. Okay students, so this was solution of your assignment. Go through the solutions properly and prepare well for the test tomorrow. Okay, thank you.